Fivescore and 12 years ago, our Toastmaster forefather, Ralph C. Smedley, then the education director of the YMCA in Bloomington, Illinois, saw the need for and created a vehicle for men in the community to learn how to speak, conduct meetings, plan programs, and work on committees. Smedley decided to organize a club where they could learn these skills in a social environment, and the men responded well to the concept. He named the group Toastmasters because it was a term that people knew, getting up in front of a crowd and raising a glass to someone. The first unofficial Toastmaster meeting was held on March 24th, 1905. Much like Toastmasters meetings today, the participants took turns leading and speaking at each meeting. The older members evaluated those speeches, and as they did more, that trained the younger, newer members how to evaluate and from watching the speeches, begin speaking themselves. Smedley, however, was offered a position at other YMCAs in Illinois and later in San Jose, California. Unfortunately, those fledgling clubs lacked leadership, which, as you said, is an important role to play in our club and in our lives. And they did not flourish. 413 years ago, after moving to Santa Ana, California, and getting the new YMCA established, Smedley proposed the idea of Toastmasters to his new colleagues. That club became club number one of Toastmasters International, and the first meeting in Santa Ana on October 22, 1924, is celebrated as the first Toastmasters meeting. In 1962, Toastmasters International moved into its first headquarters building, just down the street from where that first Toastmasters meeting was held. Ralph Smedley died in 1965. In 1970, Toastmasters International admitted its first female member, Helen Blanchard, under the name of Homer Blanchard. In 1973, Toastmasters began officially admitting women, and in 1985, Helen became Toastmasters' first female international president under her own name of Helen Blanchard. You are involved in an organization that has been around for a long time. Many people, not only Daniel, have found great value in this type of meeting, type of training, and opportunity to grow personally and professionally. Toastmasters itself is going through some morphings. The books that Daniel has just completed are going to be phased out soon, and we're going to be trained in a whole new way, have a whole new way to progress through the skills that we're learning. They still value the skills exponentially. They're trying to update the way people learn and experience their life. So stay tuned, stay involved, and by all means, keep working in your books. You've got 2 years to complete those, and they will always serve you in the future.